Hey y'all, Patrick here with Vetted. Thank you guys so much for joining. Hope you guys are having a wonderful, what is it, Tuesday? Yes, Tuesday, October 3rd. All right, I have a wonderful video for you today. Christopher Mellon has a brand new interview out on the Chris Cuomo Project. I will put a full link to the full interview. We're going to take a small look at a clip from Twitter from the interview that I found quite interesting. And we're going to react to it in real time. I haven't watched the clip. I haven't watched the full interview either. But I read this tweet and I thought it was quite interesting. So without further ado, guys, let's jump in and real quick say hi to my dog, Mac, here. I got two dogs, Mac and Rocket. Rescues. Always get a rescue. All right, let's jump in here. Here's the tweet. It's from Mike Colangelo. Hope I'm saying that right. Colangelo. I don't know. All right. Keep the ET and NHI hypothesis on the table. Christopher Mellon explains his reasoning for not ruling out the ET explanation for some UFO cases and that we all need to keep an open mind. Of course, right? That's why we're doing this. Absolutely. 2000 and some of the reasons, I guess. Okay. 2004 Nimitz case, estimate of civilizations in the Milky Way, AI and self-replicating probes, aviators, quote, it could not have been made by man. Friends at Lockheed Skunk Works. Okay, that's something we all can't relate to. Multiple sensors are capturing these unknown objects. He writes, I'm impressed that Christopher Mellon pretty much got the altitudes correct with the Tic Tac Nimitz case. Okay, interesting. All right, let's jump in here to the clip, y'all.
And then a guy like you comes with a pedigree that, like, you know, could exhaust Wikipedia, and you say that the best explanation for some of these things is that they are extraterrestrial and everybody's heads explode. Why do you believe that, and what did you want people to take from it?
So I've not taken the position that any of these things or specific cases are necessarily of extraterrestrial origin, but there are cases like the Nimitz incident where I don't know how else to explain it. And my main point is that we need to keep an open mind and not rule that out. If we look scientifically at what we know today, various astronomers, PhDs, and publications have a range of estimates about the number of intelligent civilizations that are currently existing in the Milky Way that we share this galaxy with. We know the direction of technology and artificial intelligence. We know that, so for example, one Russian, Yuri Milner, is building a spacecraft, a probe, to send to another star system, Alpha Centauri, right now. That's not even a nation state. One rich Russian guy can fund an interstellar probe. Why would we think that civilizations that might be a billion years older than us and more advanced couldn't send probes out for purposes of exploration, even possibly self-reproducing probes? So my point is really, let's follow the facts wherever they lead, keep everything on the table. And we have some cases where the aviators themselves, who were witnessing these events, they're saying it could not have been made by man. These are people who know what we can do. They've got security clearances. They're patriots, they're sober, they have 20/20 eyesight, and they're seeing objects doing things that are way beyond anything that we could do, even in our most cutting-edge programs. And I have friends at the from who've worked at the Lockheed Martin Skunk Works for decades at the point, and I talk to those guys, and they're like, there's no way, you know, we could do one or two of those things. We're talking about craft that are descending in a vertical line in a couple of seconds from 80,000 feet to 20,000 feet, hovering, instantaneously accelerating to hypervelocity, hypersonic speeds, without friction, without plasma, without breaking the sound barrier. I mean, a lot of stuff that is utterly baffling and so far beyond what we're capable of, that you naturally, you're trying to find a hypothesis that fits the facts.
And unless you just dismiss it as being fake and made up.
Yeah. So, you know, you could say, well, all those radar operators on the USS Princeton and all those aviators in the three different F-18s, which have two aviators on each and saw this thing at close range in broad daylight, combat veterans in some cases, including the squadron commander, who was the guy who got closest to it. This was an enlisted guy in the Marine Corps, got served on a carrier, decided he wanted to fly fighter jets, went back into the military, became an officer, got a college degree, became an aviator. I mean, you're talking about, you know, super gung-ho, patriotic, hardworking Americans here. We're not talking about crazy people.
Right.
Look how, pardon me, just a regular vape pen, y'all. I'm trying to quit smoking. It's working. Get a vape pen. Anyway, Chris Cuomo is cracking me up here. His face, he's just so like, yeah, right?
All either duped or dumb. Or they're completely hyper devoted, and that's very, very unlikely. But
and if I may say,
please,
it's really important that to bear in mind. Not only did they multiple pilots see it in broad daylight, but multiple radar systems confirmed
right
what they saw, and then there was an infrared video of the object on top of it. So we have, you know, maybe 10, 15 witnesses, all military, U.S. military. There's sensor data that confirms it and so forth. So I think what I'm saying is, it, of course, there's a possibility that somebody else's space program has found us in an infinite universe. This universe is so strange and so bizarre and so immense. Why would we be surprised if we encountered intelligent machines from somewhere else?
I mean, right? What do y'all think? That's kind of always been the argument, right? The universe is so big and expansive. There must be life, right? Now, not sure if I should mention this, but whatever. Dr. Brian Keating was on Joe Rogan recently, and he did have an argument against that, that just because it's big and expansive doesn't mean anything, right? Because you hear that all the time. Well, it's just so many planets, right? Billions and billions of stars with habitable planets, right? In the habitable zone. Because for us, we think, water, right? And water has a very distinct temperature range spectrum for it to be liquid and for life to exist within it. But he had an argument, like his example was Antarctica, it being so big and expansive, yet there's hardly no life. But the key there is some life. But anyway, I'll put a link to that video so you can watch that about Dr. Brian Keating if you're interested. He was on Joe Rogan and they talked about that. So because I hadn't really heard an argument against that before. But anyway, yeah, what do y'all think about this? Seems pretty obvious, right? A lot of these reasons why, again, eliminating that it's not ET, just period, just 100% saying, now, not ET, that's not good. But also 100% saying, yep, those are ET, that's also not good, right? It's like politics. Both extremes suck, right? It's the same sort of scenario. We basically, like he mentions, we have to keep an open mind till we find out what this is. And again, there's so much smoke. We have to look for a fire. I mean, that's just it. There's something going on, right? What is that thing? I'm curious what everyone's going to say in the comments. Don't forget, there's a lot of stuff supposed to be happening with disclosure in the next 12 to 18 months. That's according to Ross Coulthart. That's even according to David Grush. Now, granted, people are saying he mentioned some dates in the video with the Yes Theory that just came out about February 2024, right? This new UAP Disclosure Act, and that's going to be bringing forth disclosure. Now, granted, they're saying that was recorded after the hearing in July, before all this pushback that's happening right now in the House with that UAP Disclosure Act. Because remember, it's an amendment and the National Defense Authorization Act that doesn't get signed till the end of December, okay, by the president. And the Senate puts forth their amendments, and then the House as well. They have to approve it, and that's where we are now. So a lot of that language could change. But again, that just doesn't take away from the fact that we have to keep an open mind. And, you know, our government is, you know, as much grief as we give them about secrecy and we want transparency, they are doing some things, right? There's a lot of the Department of Energy made a video about that. They got, parts of their website, and they're releasing a lot of information to look through. NASA, Aero, this UAP Disclosure Act, right? There's just a lot going on. David Grush saying these firsthand witnesses, even more than witnesses, right? These are supposedly people that worked on these craft, worked on these UFO retrieval programs, that they're going to come forward. They're going to come forward and testify, hopefully, would be the key. So I would bet that the next hearing that we hear about, unless they bring firsthand witnesses, right? I mean, that's really the only way to go in the next hearing, because if we get another hearing and it's just people who, you know, saw something, heard about some stuff, right? I mean, we're going to need those people to come forward, unfortunately. And they know that. And look, there is, maybe they are scared. I mean, if it's true what they're saying, I totally get the fear of wanting to come forward, because people in the UFO community and skeptic community the vitriol can be insane, right? So I totally understand the fear of coming out and, you know, wanting to tell your truth. But I think just overall, the lesson here is just keep an open mind. Right. We have an open mind here, vetted. We're not saying one way or the other. We're trying to get closer to the truth. And when that happens, here we'll be. I'm willing to accept whatever that truth is. You know, but Christopher Mellon gives some great responses to why we need to keep an open mind. And there's more than that. Right. So many experiences. People that have had experiences, witnesses. I mean, it's just, there's so much, right? Are we just saying that the tens of millions of people worldwide are just lying and making things up? Military personnel, and not just our government, governments all over the world. What an odd thing to just everyone just making all this up, right? Or everyone misconstruing the same thing. There's something going on. What it is, we'll find out. So, but yes, on a side note, like what Christopher Mellon says there near the end, it's not that far-fetched that another civilization would find us with their space program, right? We're literally out looking for life on other planets, right? We have a robot on Mars. We send satellites. We collected samples from an asteroid moving through, you know, space. The idea that there just wouldn't be anything is kind of nuts. So anyway, tomorrow I'm going to be doing a video on a video that I saw with Brian Cox talking about all these different reasons why maybe we haven't seen ET. And it's a great video, and I can't wait to share it tomorrow. So look forward to that. Anyway, thank you guys again for all the support on the channel. Really appreciate it. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. And of course, hit that like button. It definitely helps the algorithm. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. We hit our goal that we wanted to hit 500 over the weekend. We surpassed it and went way past it. So thank you guys. I really mean that. Thank you guys for all the support. So anyway, we'll see you guys tomorrow on Vetted. Again, I'll put a link to the full interview with Chris Mellon and Chris Cuomo so you guys can check it out. And I'll put a link to this tweet so you can also look at this. So anyway, thanks, guys. We'll see you tomorrow. Have a good day. Remember, every day's a gift.